Need to make a personalized image for your social media like this? Then I've got a tool for you. The product I'm showing you today is called Canva, and I'm going to show you how to use it. I've got the links in the description below. You do need to set an account up, which you can do for free or get the pro version, which has some extra features. Once you have an account, you can access it from your desktop or download their Canva app and use it on your iPhone or your iPad. That has been a godsend for me, that anywhere and everywhere I can mock up a quick image as I think of it. It is extremely flexible, and I have to say working on the iPhone or iPad is very intuitive. It is designed to be easily used without the mouse. What can I produce? Well, I can produce simple images, animated images, PDFs, business cards, posts, and cover images for every social media platform, thumbnails, posters, anything you want really. My main use is in social media, but I have to say, I don't just use it for my business. I do personalized images for people's birthdays or make up my own memes. As far as social media is concerned, the wonderful part is that you can choose what style of post you need the image for, and you don't have to think about dimensions. For example, an Instagram post or a Facebook post. But if you've grabbed my cheat sheet on being able to do just one social media image that works on all platforms, then you might need to use the custom dimensions and put them in there. But the main point is that you have quick templates that you can customize as you need. You'll notice an arrow at the side that you can go to for more options. It might be that you're trying to do the thumbnail for your YouTube video that you're just putting up, or you might be doing a LinkedIn banner, and so on. Let's say I'm doing a Facebook post. I choose the dimension template that I want. It brings up a blank page. I could just go and design my own one, but the other great functionality in it is that it has design templates as well for you to choose and use. Scroll through and choose the template that you like. We'll choose one. Now don't panic if the colors or photos aren't exactly what you want. We can adjust it all. To change an item, we choose it by clicking on it. In this case, I'm choosing the photo. Let's say I'm doing a post for a hairdresser's, and it isn't exactly what I want. I can click on the photos area and choose something symbolic of what I'm after. And I drag it over and put it into that box. Now, the photos may be bigger than the box, and you can actually rearrange the photo to sit exactly how you want it. To do that, I double click on it. You'll see that it brings up the rest of the image, and I can decide that I might actually want to drag it over. Maybe I just want the fingers and the tap. I can't shrink it because I want the whole height to be there. So maybe I'm going to choose another photo. If the photo doesn't suit, you can just drag another one in instead. I can then go and change the text by just clicking on it and changing it. Now, it isn't quite right because that's a bit too wide for the word Facebook. I can either change the font style entirely into a different font or change the size so that it fits. I can also change the size by dragging the text box so you don't have to actually be changing it up in that top section all the time. I use this more on the iPhone. Maybe I want the background image to be a different color. So I click on the box and you can see that the box is highlighted, and that means I can get to this color palette option. I'm going to make it orange. And that's my image done. The image name will show up here and will default in any text that was on the image, but you can override it. Make it a helpful image name. I didn't do it here, but in a lot of mine, I add the dimensions or the social media size I've chosen, as I might do the same image, but in a couple of different size versions. And then you just choose to publish. You might link to your Facebook or other social media immediately, or you can just choose to download it. A download will appear at the bottom of your screen, and you can open it in your downloads folder. You'll notice that this one didn't cost me anything, and that's because I used a free image. The same would apply if you were using your own photos. You can choose to go for premium images, but they will cost you. You'll see them here. They've got the dollar sign and they show that they're a premium image. Basically, you sign up for a certain amount of credits on your account and use them when you download a design with a premium image. You can limit your search to only show free ones. We had text on there, but what if I needed to add a bit more text? Well, I can choose the text option. I choose the different types of fonts and styles that it has. Once again, design templates of fonts. But I'm just going to grab a bit of text and click on it, and it will appear in the middle of the page. One of the helpful features is it has guidelines in place, so you can pull design elements into alignment. As you pull it over, you'll see those guidelines in pink so that you can put it in the right spot. It also puts a line in when you're centering items in a box as well. If you're putting text between other text, it will also show you equal width grid lines as well. You can always change the alignment. It just changes as you click through. I will make it larger, bold, and coloured orange as well. There is a whole section on elements you can add: lines, shapes, frames, charts, gradients, and illustrations. They give you examples and you can search. For example, I might want a Facebook illustration. Of course, be careful with Facebook images. It is fine if you're putting it through as a post for just normal organic reach, but if you're putting it through as an ad, and then Facebook has guidelines with their trademark on how it is being displayed. In this case, I'm just doing a post with a special for the Facebook client, so I want the image on there. Most importantly, you can upload your images, logos, and branding for your company. To add an image, just press the Upload an Image button, and you can go to your computer folders and find your image. If you're using this on your iPhone, the app will take you to your camera roll to choose the photo to upload. If you start using Canva a lot, yes, you will get hooked. Then you may want to set up your own folders to group your images and designs. You can add a folder with this Create New button. The More section is for other apps that you can link to, including linking to your Facebook photos and Instagram photos so you can pull them in easily. Or you can add more images from Pexel and GIFs from Giphy, and it's great if you want to do your own memes. The Home button will save the image and take you back to your dashboard with the template designs and all your saved designs. If you want to edit one of your designs, just click on it and choose Edit. Or click on the three dots in the corner, and let's say I want to make a copy of it, and the copy will appear. I can edit it, and this one was sized for Instagram. I'm going to change it to be a Facebook size post by going to the Resize button and choosing Facebook Post. And note, there is a custom dimension option at the top. And I just adjust my images and boxes around to fit this shape. And that's now my Facebook version, and I can download it. It's a very friendly tool, and now that we've done the basics, I'll be getting out some quick tips in the future on things like doing watermarks, animations, PDFs, creating transparent files, uploading branding, inserting hyperlinks, color overlays on photos, or shadow effect text. Keep your eye out for those wonderful tips that are coming.
Thanks for watching the video. Please like or share it, and subscribe to make sure you get future tips.